we often do things we don't like. So, why not make them fun? Imagine life as a game filled with rewarding mechanisms that drive us to take action effortlessly, finding joy even in the boring tasks. Games have ways to grow, quests to complete, and rewards to earn. Life does too. Question: how do we run our lives like a game? Yukai Chu, author of Actionable Gamification, revealed the answers with something called the Octalysis Framework. This concept outlines 8 core drives of gamification that can make our lives more engaging. Now, let's create a life RPG based on these 8 core drives that track our progress and build habits. Of course, powered by Notion. In this game, we'll include things from the Octalysis Framework, like development, scarcity, avoidance, social influence, unpredictability. But first, we need the epic meaning and calling. It sets the fundamental framework and direction for the game of life. A life without clear goals is like being lost without a map. Empty characterizations and unclear meanings can lead to a lack of a sense of mission for the player. So, let me think about how this should be presented in the game. I'll be back soon. Let me just add it to the pending list. The key to this core drive is responsibility and autonomy. In games, we know the character is ours, so we take the initiative to improve their skills and find better equipment for them. This process is autonomous. No one tells us to do it, but we still enjoy it. It's because we feel attached to the characters we create, we feel responsible for them. We want them to get better so they can face stronger enemies. The author of the book says that if a person spends a lot of time customizing their profile or avatar, they will naturally feel a stronger sense of ownership over it. So, we're going to design a character feature that lets players invest in their characters and see themselves in them. Feel a sense of responsibility for this character, enjoying the happiness and motivation that comes with the character leveling up. Here, we can see character information, level, coin held, health point, goal completion rate, and level up progress bar. In the game, we complete quests to gain experience and equipment. This drive to develop the character's level. Enhance their skills. This is where a skill tree comes in. A well-designed skill tree gives players a sense of growth. Characters just need to complete specific growth tasks to enhance their skills. Developing good habits is an essential part of personal growth. That's why we need to design a sensible habit-forming mechanism. Let's make it. So, when our character practices good habits, they earn experience points and rewards. Of course, we can decide how much experience is given, adjusting the reward based on the difficulty of maintaining the good habit. And for now, let's put bad habits aside. We will come back to it later. Next up, we need a task manager. After some research, I think the para method might be a great fit for the system. Para stands for projects, areas, resources, and archives. Area is seen as a long-term responsibility you want to manage, which perfectly aligns with my skill tree system. Just like a skill tree, you need to nurture your financial and writing skills over time. A project can be thought of as the work you are doing under a certain area, and there are many more tasks under one project. For example, if your project is learning stock investment, it falls under the finance area. This project might include several tasks, like taking an online course, finishing an investment book, and researching investment platforms. In the game, a project is seen as a stage, and tasks are seen as quests under that stage. I can set how many coins and experience points each project will grant. The system automatically calculates these points and coins, and distributes them evenly across all tasks under the project. The book mentions that people need to find various creative combinations to tackle a problem. In games, when we can't defeat a boss, we try everything possible to overcome it. We experiment with different strategies, skill combos, and even try to exploit bugs to beat the game. It's crucial to see the results of our creativity and receive immediate feedback. I picked up on a key idea here: creative results and timely feedback. To shorten the feedback loop, I need to visualize numerical growth after completing specific habits or tasks. This acts like an automated diary, logging what you've done and what tasks you've completed every minute. I don't know if you agree, but I believe humans can easily become addicted to seeing numbers grow. If you've ever managed a social media platform, you'll know what I mean. But numbers without meaning can leave us feeling empty. We must give these numbers value and significance. This is a drive to get what you want, but can't. The book introduces an interesting concept called appointment dynamics. In the game, for a rare piece of equipment that we can't buy right now, we'll try to grind in dungeons, save up coins, and then buy it from the market. No one tells us to do this. It comes from our own drive and autonomy. In games, this is represented by loot drops, mission rewards, and market. So, I created a marketplace in Life RPG. I earn coins by completing tasks and goals to get rewards, and go to the market to add items to the shopping cart, pay for the item, and view the payment history. I can buy things even if I don't have money. Let's add that to the pending list. Rewards mean there are also punishments. Games are addictive because they tap into our fear of loss. In games, if you don't log in for a day, you might miss out on certain rewards. Dying might mean losing experience points, coins, or even the characters you have worked hard to build. This core drive is based on the desire to avoid negative outcomes. To align with this core drive, I have designed 3 rules. I need to sign into the system every day to check in your good habits. If I performed a good habit yesterday but forgot to check in, I will need to buy a catch-up pass in the black market. Remember the bad habits we put on the pending list? I see overcoming bad habits as a battle, where I must fight and eliminate my bad habits. When I indulge in a bad habit, it means I've lost the battle, resulting in a loss of health points. And characters will die if they have 0 health points. If characters could just come back to life without any consequences, nobody would care. So I've designed a death penalty. After dying, I lose all my coins, levels, and experience points. Pressing the respawn means the character has to start over. This punishment might not be severe enough. I need to set a stricter penalty for myself. After dying, the player, which is me, must execute a real-world penalty for the character. For example, wearing women's clothes and posting it on my Twitter. Or follow Life RPG on Product Hunt. Great games have a strong social aspect. We enjoy doing things together with others like a group, and it's turning even the most boring tasks into something fun. We need a group of people to share our achievements and to talk about our struggles. But it's not just about companionship and sharing. There's also competition and envy involved. When you see a friend mastering a skill or owning a rare item, it motivates you to reach the same level. So, I wanted to create a community. But it is not possible to do this with Notion. I thought about creating a game forum, but that wouldn't integrate with the game itself. I wanted this community to be built into the game, not just a separate website. I spent an entire afternoon thinking about it. And I really did it. I created a built-in chat room in Notion. Players can share their progress, what goals they've achieved, what skills they have, their daily life, and meet new friends. Now, I have perfected a game to manage my life, and I plan to launch it on Product Hunt next month.
Hold up! Wait a minute!
Remember the pending list we talked about earlier? I've just added a new item to it. Let's tackle the first issue. What is epic meaning and callings? It's different for everyone, and I need to find my own, just as you need to find yours. To better outline my epic meanings and callings, I created a vision board. Next up, buying things without money. In Notion, I can't stop you from clicking the buy button. I can only pop up a warning, but I do not think that's enough to curb user behavior. How about an overdraft penalty? If your account goes into the negatives, each week you'll lose health points equivalent to your negative coin balance. And now, the most important issue. How can I make it more user-friendly? The database is a mess, and it would be a hassle for users to enter their character information one by one. I need to build a create an account page to make it easier for users to start using the system. Your life, your rules. I can't set the life rules for you. I need to make a settings page where users can set up their own skill trees and experience point rates. Lastly, if you remember the Octalysis framework, you'll notice that our game design is missing an element, unpredictability and curiosity. In games, we delight in exploring maps and mechanics fueled by our curiosity and the element of unpredictability. This is also a key element that drives our autonomy, but I can't figure out how to integrate this element into the game. I need your ideas. This project has now entered the beta phase, and you can get the Life RPG beta version for free in the video description below. Life RPG is also featured on Product Hunt. If you're interested, click notify me. You can also reach out to me on Twitter with more valuable ideas. Thank you, and stay tuned.